Hello friends, today we look into an awesome scientifically proven method to reduce your watering frequency for your plants from daily to once in a week by using just 1 teaspoon of sap around your potted plants or even ground plants. I'll demonstrate you how to use it and check the moisture levels using a moisture testing tools from day 1 to day 7 and also discuss some science behind this and all that is coming up. If you are a hobby gardener, consider subscribing to this channel. Also turn on the notification bell icon so that you won't miss any updates. Well, what we are basically doing here is we are creating mini water reservoirs or mini water storage houses for your plants. These reservoirs provide a stable supply of water and nutrients to your plants. We increase the soil water holding capacity to 500 to 1000 times. This is really useful, especially in drought prone areas or if you have water shortage. This method helps to conserve water, save your valuable time, manpower, and even perhaps money. Not only in summer, but also at many other times, like when you're having water shortage, and also it's a great hack when you're on a vacation. One more benefit of this is it also reduces the quantity and frequency of fertilizer application. The research article links to this video are provided in the video description. You can check the detailed articles on this gardening idea. Well, now how to perform this hack? Actually, I'm experimenting this method and showing you how it works. I have taken 2 containers of identical size and soil, plus the identical plants of almost the same size, because watering requirement may vary between different plant species and also different plant sizes. So I have taken identical plants and labeling one container as T, that is test plant, and the other one as C, that is the control plant. We'll obviously be adding sap substance to test container and not to the control. Both of these are water only ones, that is on day 1, and the moisture levels are checked daily or on alternate day basis. So now let's look into the procedure and how to add this substance, that is the sap substance, to your plants. If you're doing this on your existing potted plants, you need to dig out some holes around your plant. You can keep the depth of each hole to about 3 to 4 inches depending on your plant size and the root system. Do this carefully and make sure you do not damage or dig out the roots. You can use any tool like a screwdriver or even a pipe. Make some 4 to 6 holes around your plant, depending on your pot size and also the plant size. Then if your plant has a larger water requirement, then dig much deeper holes based on your plant size and also the plant stem caliber. Now add just 1 or 2 grams of this sap material into each hole. 1 teaspoon, I think it's about 4 to 5 grams. So add about 1 to 2 grams approximately into each hole and then cover this with the soil. Then add about 1/2 to 1 liter of water depending on your container size. I'll discuss about what is this sap compound shortly, but be assured that this is a fully biodegradable and non-toxic substance. One more method you can use this sap substance is if you're repotting any plant, you can mix about 1 to 2 teaspoons of this stuff into your potting mix. Mixing it with soil results in a light, fluffy, aerated, well-draining soil. But do not use this for your succulents and also similar plants which do not require so much of water. So now, before discussing on what is sap, we'll now show you the result of this experiment. On day 1, after adding this substance and then water, you have to leave it for an hour for the material to absorb water. Now you can test the moisture level using handy tool, that is a very useful tool which measures pH, moisture and light levels. The link to purchase this is on my website, that is gkvk.in. One more point to clarify, that this is not a promotional video where I'm promoting some company stuff and things like that. On my website, I've listed only those items which I've purchased and tested personally. Well, I've kept both pot T and pot C in the same location and similar climatic conditions, and that is under my 50% shade house, to receive the same amount of sunlight. Make sure these are not watered daily. And in case if you're expecting rain, you can shift to a safer location to protect them from rain. Now on day 1, after watering both test and control pots, the moisture level is very good in both containers, showing fully wet in the moisture meter. It's not one point in the soil. I'm checking all around the soil. That is at around 3 to 4 spots into the soil. After 2 days, you can see the moisture level has remained nearly the same in test pot. That is, it is still completely wet. And the control pot moisture level has slightly fallen down from wet to the moist zone. On day 3, you can see the test pot is still wet and the control pot is showing dry. This means it needs watering immediately. The results may vary depending on your zone's climatic conditions. Well, on day 5, you can see there is a fall in moisture level, but still it's showing moist and can continue for a day or two. You can either water your plant at this point of time or wait for another 2 days and then rewater so that the hygroscopic material, that is water absorbing crystals, take up this water and hold on, and then supply this to your plant for another week. So this proves the effectiveness of this method, and you do not need to water your plant frequently and your plant remains content, happy and healthy. This is really useful, especially when in summer or even if you're going on a vacation. So now let's quickly learn what is this sap and what is the cost of this substance and where it's available. Sap is nothing but super absorbent polymer or hydrophilic or hygroscopic polymer chains, or sometimes also called as hydrogel substance. It is an eco-friendly, non-toxic, harmless, biodegradable material with some good water absorption and water holding capacity, ranging from 100 to 1000 times water retention to its weight. Different grades of sap are available for different purposes with different capacities. Water beads or water crystal balls, what your kids play, are also similar to this hygroscopic polymers. They are usually sodium polyacrylate and used for similar purposes. In agriculture, they are used as water reservoirs within the soil and they absorb the water when it is raining and release it back when it is dry. Now, how much does this cost? This is not too costly. I got this 250 grams of sap for about $4. Maybe it's much cheaper if purchased in larger quantities. You can find the link to purchase this in the description, and also almost all products that I have purchased or tested are listed on my website, that is gkvk.in. It's not a functional store but a catalog of links of items which I have purchased and those that I recommend. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share the video and pass some comments or suggestions below the video. Consider subscribing to the channel if you're new to the channel with the bell notification icon pressed. Happy gardening!